search for the Fountain of Youth. As it turns out, many NFL players have already found it.
Señor Ray Lewis.
He's old as hell. Come on. For a football player, he's old. There's two people who generally wear out first. There's those who get tackled and those who do the tackling. There's punishment. There's punishment. Always tackling people.
You can't hurt this. I'm a machine, jerk.
I mean, one thing talking about a kicker or a quarterback, but you're hitting every single play.
Ray Lewis, the ageless wonder.
That's a grind right there. I mean, what did Buckus and those guys play? 8 years, you know, 9 years, and this guy's 17?
I look at Ray Lewis and I think of Cal Ripken, who did it at shortstop. Ray Lewis, same thing, middle linebacker. I mean, these guys did it, and they did it at the position that...
...or throw it to win a game.
George Brandon has just been...
Favre joined the Jets and Vikings for 3 seasons and became the only quarterback in NFL history to beat all 32 teams.
I was there at the Meadowlands the day he threw the 6 touchdown passes against the Cardinals.
Brett Favre sets an all-time career high for a single game.
He was rolling there for a while.
18 years in the league, bro. That's almost my entire life.
Like a Tiffany or a Cartier.
Jared Allen nicknamed him the Silver Fox.
The Silver Fox!
When he took that helmet off, Jay Leno was blushing. Michael McDonald of the Doobie Brothers was blushing. His hair had become almost completely white.
Before retiring for good, Favre rewrote the record books, including the
The talent to play the sport that I so dearly love for almost 3 decades.
The only pressures that I had was people talking about where he's on the backside of his career.
Certain age, when he got past that certain age, the wonder was, I wonder